Hello everyone, I'm Claudio De Luca from CNR Area of Naples, and in this work I present a joint exploitation of the GNSS data with PISBAS algorithm for the estimation of the ground displacement at national or continental scale. Let us first focus on the line of sight DINSAR displacement, whose expression can be written as the sum of five elements, in particular the high spatial frequency displacement, the low spatial frequency displacement, a noise contribution due to atmospheric phase screen, the high spatial frequency noise effect mainly due to the phase unwrapping errors, and the low spatial frequency artifact due to the possible inaccuracy of the orbital parameters and atmospheric residuals. About the estimation of phase unwrapping errors and atmospheric phase screen filtering, PISBAS algorithm already implements solution to reduce this effect, and for this reason in this work we concentrate on the estimation of the low spatial frequency artifact to increase the quality of the DINSAR analysis. In particular, the implemented procedure makes use of a joint exploitation of GNSS stations with DINSAR analysis. On the right side of this slide we have a block diagram of the implemented procedure, which starts from the GNSS time series available. Then it continues with the time series filtering operation, and then the evaluation of a similarity index on the GNSS planar velocity component, north-south and east-west component, aimed at estimating the GNSS station which are strongly spatial correlated and so only affected by regional or tectonic movement. Then we use these selected GNSS stations to refine the DINSAR analysis and to create a value-added DINSAR product. More in detail, in this work we exploit all the GNSS stations on European territory freely available from Nevada Geodetic Laboratory website. After a first GNSS time series filtering procedure, for a more accurate estimation of the deformation velocity components, we only selected stations that have a planar velocity components with a high value of the similarity index within 30 km². In this slide is shown the effect of the implemented procedure for the GNSS station selection with the similarity index. The picture A represents the east-west component of all GNSS stations available before the selection procedure. C instead represents the north-south one. B and D represent the corresponding velocity of the selected station after the screening procedure, and as evident, the selected station are strongly spatial correlated with no evident singularity signals. After the selection of the reliable GNSS station starts the procedure for the refinements of the DINSAR signals. In this slide, I show you an example of DINSAR processing performed with the PISBAS algorithm over the Central Italy region. In particular, the picture A represents the mean displacement velocity map obtained with the PISBAS approach, while B is the low spatial frequency deformation pattern retrieved from the selected GNSS stations. A and B together correspond to the input for the velocity calibration procedure. The calibration is essentially equivalent to a low-pass spatial filter for the estimation and removal of possible artifacts. C and D are the obtained results. In particular, C shows the results of the calibration step that allow us to retrieve the high spatial deformation signal, while D is the sum of B plus C and corresponds to the overall deformation signal, low and high spatial frequency deformation components. It is important noting that all the GNSS stations excluded from the refinement procedure can be used for the quality assessment of the PISBAS results. Indeed, on the right side of this slide, we compare the PISBAS results with the measurements retrieved from the excluded GNSS stations. To conclude, in this slide I show you the results of the PISBAS algorithm combined with the developed refinement procedure over the European territory by exploiting the full Sentinel-1 data archive. Thank you for your attention.